Okay, so I have a confession to make. I made some modifications to my LE5040 laser engraver, and the modifications worked. The laser engraver is fine. The problem is, I kind of accidentally permanently deleted all the video that I shot of that. So unfortunately, I can't show you the process of actually doing the mods. So what I'll try to do is tell you what I did, and hopefully you'll be able to figure it out from there. So without any further ado, let's take a look at some footage from my assembly video to point out what the issues are, and then I'll explain what the fixes are that I did to the laser.
If you remember from the assembly instructions where we attached the controller board to the acrylic piece, the hardware provided for this is a little bit too long, and I've come up with a modification that fixes this. Here's a reminder of what we ran into.
What's going on? They're all doing that. They're bumping into each other, aren't they? Am I using the right bolts? All right, let's do a little math here. We have M38 bolts. We have a M38 hex nut. Okay, so that means that this guy is 8 millimeters long. So we have 4 millimeters from each one of these bolts can go in until they run into each other. That leaves a total of 8 millimeters left. The problem is this is only 4.5 millimeters approximately. That's 4.5, and the board about 1.7, 1.6, one something like that. So 4.5, 5.5, 6, just over 6 millimeters. So we've got 2 millimeters extra on these bolts.
If you look at this picture, you can see a fancy finish washer on the back of the acrylic sheet. This washer gives us enough extra space to take up the almost 2 millimeters of excess that we had given the hardware provided. This is a nice looking fix and it seems to hold really well. I did contact SaneSmart about this. Their suggestion was to use zip ties to hold the PC board on, and I thought that wasn't very permanent and not a real good solution. So I stopped by my favorite local hardware store, picked up these finish washers, and cost $1.75 for a pack of 10, and now I've got 6 left over. So it's a good fix and easy to do. So something, if you're running into this, this is how you might want to go about fixing it. The second issue that we ran into was on the laser assembly, the way that it actually rides on the gantry. The spacing between the 4 V-bearings, basically the lower two and the upper two, the spacing is slightly too large, which means there's a little wiggle room as the laser moves back and forth. Normally not an issue, but it's just not tidy to have it that way. It's possible that that could jiggle back and forth and mess up your cut. So what I did was I basically just took that X-axis rail off. There's 4 bolts. Popped that off, and I put a piece of electrician's tape or electrical tape along the bottom of the rail real lightly, and then ran the head across it with the V-grooves to push that down in where it needed to be, and then I packed it down or tacked it down well with my fingers to make sure that it was sticking. That's all the difference or the distance that it needs. Just that tape thickness was all it needs, and it sits in there nicely now.
Oops.
Hi, I'm AT from CNC at Home. If you like our content, help support our channel by clicking on subscribe and liking our videos. Thank you for watching this video. Have fun with your CNC at Home projects.